Hello everybody, this is Zorak47, and today we're going to be taking a look at one of my all-time favorite RPG games, Kingdoms of Amalur: Reckoning. Now, a lot of people don't know about this game. It's old in the gaming world, came out, if I remember right, in 2012. Now, this game, while it has been out for several, I guess at this point it's many years, it holds up very well. It's still one of my all-time favorite RPG games that's ever been made. And we're going to dive right on into a new game here, just on the normal difficulty. I'm going to try to bust through this. Now, for some reason, on my previous playthrough, I didn't make it very far, only about an hour in. However, I had the same issue where I did not get any audio on this opening cutscene right here, and I have not been able to solve the issue, but pretty much all this is the beginning of the Tuathan invasion. I'm going to go ahead and skip this cinematic so we can jump into it without anybody getting all weird that they don't have audio. I'm aware, and I have honestly no idea how to fix it, because I just installed the game, clean install, already having this issue. So far the rest of the game seems solid though, so we're just going to go ahead and skip this.
What do you think this one is then? Alpha? The Run? Could even be a Jotun.
Always a surprise, eh, Gran?
Eyes on the job, boy. Don't matter what it is. Dead's dead. And be thankful for that. All we've seen. Go on and pull back the sheet, though. It'll need to be in our report, one way or the other.
Gotta love it when you die immediately, first thing in the game. You're already dead. It's wonderful. Alright, so you got your four races here. Obviously you have your gender, it can be male or female. I'm gonna go with male for the purposes of this. And we have our four races. The Almain, our warlike and religious nation of storied origin. Basically, your standard human. They make for great warriors. Persuasion, alchemy bonuses, as well as a big one in blacksmithing, which is great for making your own weapons and armor. You have your Varani, which are pretty much, I would go for, roguish. They favor swords and daggers. You got your mercantile, lockpicking, and detect hidden. The lockpicking is good for rogue types as well as the detect hidden. Your Jocelfar are kind of your higher born, I would say. Also would be your best bet for a mage with their racial bonuses, just of dispelling, sagecraft, and alchemy. And then finally you have your Docklefar, which I don't know exactly how to class them as a race, but they'd be good for a rogue or mage type. If you want to do a combo, that would be perfect for them with their sagecraft, persuasion, and stealth bonuses. And this line right here, while they do not shy from conflict, they prefer to resolve disputes subtly and with grace, or efficiently in silence. Perfect rogue sentence right there. But it's up to you. All of these races with their bonuses, you don't have to follow that. You can make an Almain mage rogue if you'd like. It really doesn't matter other than the beginning bonus there. I'm gonna go with Almain because I'm gonna do a warrior here. And next you have your choice of deity. Basically you choose your god, Vrakor, god of fire, and patron of the forge. Athene, goddess of wisdom and art. Theodon, god of war, battle, and tactics. Honestly great for a warrior. Mitharu, god of order. Yindan, god of justice, and no deity at all. Now, with these, they do each have their own bonuses as far as picking one. God of Fire, Patron of the Forge, you get a 6% fire damage and 6% fire resistance, which is, useful. Wisdom, 10% mana, 5% physical damage, 5% armor, 5% health, 5% mana. 10% health, and 1% experience bonus. While that 1% experience bonus does not sound like a lot, and frankly it isn't, it's like saving pennies. In the beginning, it's nothing, doesn't really count, but once you make it up through several levels, save your pennies for a few weeks, couple months, whatever it may be, you end up with, you know, $5, $10, $100, depending how long you're doing it. It's the same thing with this experience bonus. While it's very little, it will stack and it ends up being a very substantial amount by the end game. But for the sake of a warrior, I'm going to go with Theoden, God of War, Battle and Tactics, because I would greatly like that 5% physical damage and 5% armor bonus. Both are wonderful for a warrior. Next, we have the character creation, which is a lot of people's favorite part about an RPG. This one does a little differently. You have to pick a preset. However, once you select one, you go into in-depth character creation. But for I like this guy, give you a look at all of the presets here. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. I like 3, just that red hair tattoo on his face. He just looks badass and menacing as hell, and he's my favorite, so we're just gonna go with him. And then you jump right into the in-depth creation where you can change your face, skin tone, eye color, stubble color, your basic character creation for RPGs. The only thing you can't change is the body type, which for the most part, not a huge deal. They look fairly burly and badass anyway, depending on who you choose. The Almain, he looks like a natural warrior, so it fits perfectly. The only thing I'm going to change is I'm going to get rid of the jewelry. There's really nothing behind that, it's just a personal preference I have. Just to keep the face clean, don't want to catch on anything in any combat, just seems practical to me. And that's all I'm going to change, and we're going to confirm him.
A human. And not in bad shape. Almain by the look of him. You know how you can tell? Turn him over. See if there's a stick in his ass.
Well, that's just rude.
All right, then. Make sure it goes into the report. You know he'll want all the details.
Amazing how well the body held up. Better than I've seen.
I'm just glad it's not moving. Must have been born under a lucky star, this one.
Anything else we need?
Unless you'd like to name him, I think we're done. Put him with the others.
I'd like to name me, if it's all the same with you guys. And looky there, we have a name. So, given just what we're going for here, I'ma just go ahead and name him Zorak. May not be all that creative, but you know, I'm happy with it. It works for me. Now, I know you may have noticed that clicking in the back, that is my keyboard, and that sound is the primary reason why I use a controller for this game, and all the games on my channel so far.
Well, that's it for you then. Better luck next time.
Gee, thanks. Probably like everybody would get tired of hearing the mechanical clicks of my keyboard. So until I get a quieter keyboard or a better mic, we'll just go with controller. And that is a terrifying place to wake up, my god. Ugh, I can see the stench. And, you know, I'm sure those flies are loving this. Oh, God. That splash. Corpse goose. Corpse goo. Disgusting. See, look at him. He's just built like a warrior. a little bit swagger as he walks to. He thinks he's tough shit. That's nice. This whole place is falling apart. Alright, so let's see. We're gonna take a look right here, see what we got here. Secrecy is still important in our work, requiring specialized disposal of our unfortunate failures. Piling remains have become a concern in the lower caverns, so an incinerator has been added to deal with the wastes. An incinerator has been added. Why would you not start with an incinerator? Whatever. This should make disposal work slightly less horrible. Although you should avoid drinking water from downstream of the ash dumps. Hardly a fitting rest for the poor things, but if it's any consolation, these weren't their original bodies in the first place. Former as Hughes. Wow. Would avoid drinking water from downstream of the ash dumps. I don't even know where to start. That's one hell of a sentence. Ah. Ooh, we get to burn this guy? Hell yeah. Sizzle. And a rusty sword. Alright, I like a rusty sword. I'll take it. Hell yeah. A rusty long sword. You know, that would look really awesome if it wasn't rust. Here's like some nice decorative art or something on there, like some flames. Make it swing faster. But no, it's gotta be rust.
Run.
To Arthur.
Scatter, children of dust! Scatter before the might of the Tuatha!
Tuatha are basically the invading force, the big bad enemy. Yeah, every RPG needs it. Mass Effect, it'd be the Reapers. Here, it's the Tuatha. And giant rats. Get a sword, why not attack some rats? Ow! Got rat aids. Jesus.
Stay away!
And like, you know, other similar RPGs, you can break the hell out of anything. Destroy everything, you find gold in here, occasionally a health potion. And most of the time, just nothing.
Help! Anybody!
I'm somebody. I will help.
You! Up there! Please help me! Please!
More mortals to come.
How great is your armor when you're beaten by a rusty sword? Ooh. Loot. Battered armor. And some more leggings. Dope.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. If you hadn't come along, wait. I've seen you before. On the slab, you were dead. It worked. By the tome, it worked. You're alive.
Indeed, I am. But what happened to me?
You died. I don't know how or even where. But your body was remade in the Well of Souls, and somehow, it worked. The well restored your soul to your body, and it worked. We must get you to Professor Hughes right away. He'll have questions for you.
Who are these attackers?
Oh my, you don't know? Perhaps the process damaged your memory. They are the Tuatha Deo, the enemies of all the young races. We've never seen them this far inland. Not even during the invasion. I don't know why they are here. Hughes may have the answer to that as well. You must stay alive and reach him.
I do plan on staying alive. I have some questions myself.
Oh, no doubt. But we must get to Hughes. He'll be in his study on the ground floor. The Tuatha are coming in through the lower levels. If we hurry, we should be able to beat them to the top. Take these. They'll help keep you safe long enough to get to Hughes. Now let's get going.
Woo! Minor healing potion. Hell yeah. The Well of Souls.
The Well of Souls is just ahead. You'll see. And it works. It restored you to life. There will be plenty of time to explain later.
We've got to get going.
Death.
I wish I could tell you more. You showed no signs of life when we removed your new body from the well's waters. We just put it in the furnace room with the others. We would have never done that if we knew.
The attackers.
Oh, my. You don't know? Perhaps the process damaged your memory. They are the Tuatha De Oh, the enemy of all the young races.
Deja vu.
I've never seen them this far inland. Not even during the invasion. I don't know why they're here.
First one. All right. Where's Hughes?
He'll be in his study on the ground floor of the tower. At least, I hope he's there. And safe. Let me get this door.
Well, let's get going.
We can be on our way.
Ooh, some gold. Yeah.
Right this way.
Oh, look at all these boxes. Clutter. Clutter. Cool, a chest. A nice big chest. My favorite. Old boots. And with that, we are gonna equip ourselves some armor. We'll go for the battered armor over the tattered shirt. Worn leggings over ragged leggings. What a fancy man I am. And some old boots. Yep. That is classy. What do we got over here? Like most RPG games, this is full of secrets. The only question is, can you find them all?
This
and the answer is no.
Our greatest invention, the no. Well of Souls.
I probably won't.
An end to war. An end to death.
Oh, that's gonna explode. Yep, yep, I called that. Giant magical time bombs. Lovely. And more corpse water. Fantastic. Ooh, a lever! Pull the lever, Grunk! More boxes.
The storerooms.
Damn you, rebel.
Find anything useful.
Ooh, another chest. Gold. Horn gloves. Finally, some hand protection. Yeah. Now we're rocking. We look like a scrub. Crude iron shield. That could be worse.
Wait. Do you hear something? Oh, Tuatha!
Tuatha!
Let us smoke the bait. The molten gold.
You're no match for me. And my ragged leggings and rusty sword.
Any more than just that sword. That one had a bow. Get it?
A bow. I'll take a bow. Alright, so this is kind of like a tutorial of sorts. We're going to go through every, well, most of the weapon types and how to use them, as well as not exactly classes, but the weapons. And how they work. So, with a bow and arrow, in the top left you have your arrow count. Typically it starts at 5. And they do regenerate, so you don't have to worry about finding more. So you use 2 arrows, have 3 remaining. They regenerate, all 5 are back. And you hold it and it charges it for a more powerful attack. As opposed to just firing them off. Which is still kind of fun. Dotted documents. The writing on these documents are too faded to be of value. Well, I'm gonna take it anyway. I'm gonna take everything. It's my loot. It's all my loot. Loot. Rusty leg plates. Ooh-hoo, are we coming into mail? Are we coming into some plate? Yeah, look at that. That's a plate armor. That's warrior-tastic.
Daggers are deadly if you catch an enemy unaware.
And some daggers. Daggers are fun. Crude iron daggers.
More than makes up.
Works for me, really. And some rusty gauntlets. Sounds like more plate, too. Yeah. Gauntlets.
More up ahead. If you can sneak up on them with your daggers, you should be able to finish them quickly and quietly.
And this is a rogue aspect. The sneaking with the daggers, as well as this stealth care we're gonna be doing. All very roguey aspects. And yet still some of my favorite. Ooh, loot. Anti curious. That's probably some plate. Yeah, look at that. That looked like a warrior. Sneak up on one of these guys since they're too close together and we're only gonna be able to get one.
Look at the mortal burn.
We're gonna stab the other with these daggers. Show you how those work a little bit. Very quick, very efficient weapons. Not horribly high on the damage output, but they are by far probably the quickest weapon in the game. Hence, you know, they're daggers, you kind of expect them to be.
Cave blossoms only respond in the presence of magic. Perhaps there is more to you than...
I am magic.
What are you?
I'm a goddamn wizard! Ooh, a document. Hughes, per your request, we finally got the spider problem under control. Claude will try to take credit for an efficient cleansing with his Praetorians, but I feel he overstates his case and fails to recognize the value that my own quick thinking and scholarly work provided to the successful operation. Oh, he's one of those people, huh? You hear that? High class, I'm better than you attitude? While overseeing the spider purge, I noticed that those gods who were affected by spider venom exhibited stiffness of joints and tightening of skin. Symptoms would suggest a possible solution for the internal cohesion problems of some of the well's creations. I would have studied these symptoms in more depth at the time, but the guards willfully and flagrantly disobeyed my orders to delay application of antitoxins. Yes, how dare they not want to die of spider venom. As such, I request that we capture some of these spiders in order to harvest their venom and for future testing. Furthermore, I trust that these insubordinate guards will be punished immediately. For my steadfast pursuit of knowledge, I require no medal nor promotion. All I would ask is that you please reassign me off of subject disposal detail, Gurion. Well, that is a charmer, ain't he? Oh God. Oh, that's not okay. Giant spiders. No spiders. There's always spiders. Some mage gear. Just take it off. Why is it always spiders? Every single RPG game there's spiders. Why? Why does it have to be goddamn spiders all the goddamn time? Nice big chest helps. Worn hand drops. More mage gear. Not gonna use it, but, you know. Oh, we're gonna fight a spider down here, aren't we? Oh, God. Yep. Use that shocker. Stab, stab. Oh, God. Always spiders. Why? Why is it always spiders? If you couldn't tell, I'm not a fan of spiders. But we just picked up a staff. And staffs are mage weapons as opposed to the rogue longbow and daggers. And mage weapons are, quite frankly,
covered the tunnel. Maybe you can use that staff to
extremely badass.
Not more spiders.
Allow me to give an example. There are different types of staffs for the elements, as one would suspect. This is a fire staff, you have an ice staff, an electrical staff, and I believe a wind staff, one for each element. And they are insanely powerful, especially as you go up in levels and increase your ability to use them. They also have another weapon, it'll be a while before I come across it, but I believe they're called Chakrams. And those are my favorite weapons in the game. They're insanely powerful, they have a good range, and that is the number one reason I would personally play a mage, is for their particular weapons.
Hurry, get out of here!
No shit, I want to get out of here. There's spiders everywhere. Who likes that shit? Now, with that being said, there's a very good chance of me doing another playthrough of this game with a mage. Because, as I said, the mages are insanely powerful. Not only at the higher levels, but even just starting off, you can kick some serious ass.
Die, twat and bastard!
A lot of people are not used to.
Get alive. I lose this.
Most mages you need
That's
to,
what I intend to find out.
Build up to
he came
the,
out of the well.
Ass kickery.
What? Then he'd better get inside to see the old man. Quick, before those twatha make another push. This is where we part ways. But take whatever you want from this armory. We might have a few things that would fit you. Just make sure you get to choose. We can hold off the twatha here.
I need more help. This right here is the first time you're going to see a persuasion test. If anybody has ever played old school like sheet D&D, you'll know the persuasion test, a dice roll. However, here it's still a roll. At this point, you would basically need a 1 or 2 to be a failure. Anything else is a success. And we can up this chance later by putting skills into persuasion. I think is the name of the skill, but you can see it's a 95% chance of success, and it being that high will almost definitely succeed, so I'm gonna do that. I need more help.
I suppose these might be
persuasion succeeded.
If the Twatha realize what you are, you'll need them.
And we got some little potions. I can fight with you.
We can't risk you getting killed. You're proof that the well can work. Don't you realize what that means?
No.
Just keep going past the top of the well. Hughes will be there in his study. I'll see you on the outside, if fate wills it.
All right, so. Good looting.
Plate armor. Nothing protects quite like layers of impervious metal.
I wholeheartedly agree. Plate is the way to go.
Leather armor is thin, but will give you the speed to reach an enemy's throat.
Rogue armor, and this has to be mage armor.
Cloth frees your body and mind. That's why mages prefer it.
Very good, very good. I'm going to go ahead and equip this plate armor. Discarding the other ones, we're going to add them to junk. Just because I have no real use for them. So, and that'll make it easier to sell them later. These two are the same. I'm going to get rid of the new one. I'm not going to use robes. These rusted gauntlets are already equipped. Right. Screwed that up. I'm going to get rid of the other ones. Rusty leg plates. Get rid of the worn leggings. And these are the same. Both have a 30 out of 30 durability. 8 armor. And a plus 5 melee block efficacy. Efficiency. So, doesn't really matter. Gonna get rid of the one we're not wearing. And the old boots beat the old shoes. We did get a repair kit, which as you can see on this one, it has a 16 out of 17 durability left. As you fight, take damage, whatever it may be, your durability will decrease on your items, and a repair kit will help bring it back up. An item with a durability of 0 out of whatever. Once it hits zero, it basically no longer counts as being equipped. You can have it equipped, but you will not get any of the bonuses from it because the item is considered destroyed. Now, even once it's at zero and it's considered destroyed, you can use a repair kit and to repair it, and you'll get all the bonuses back as well as the armor from it. Just an interesting little side note. Now, we are almost out of time here, but it looks like we've almost made it to Professor Hughes, so I'm going to keep going a little longer. And this may run over our half-hour mark here. Whoa. But I think it'll be worth it if we get to Professor Hughes and hopefully out of this damn place. Ooh, progress log. Experiments are now successfully recreating bodies 97.5% of the time. Any missing limbs or extra fingers are now probably how the original subject looked, rather than a magical flux on our end. However, full revivification still eludes us, even with increased testing products. Products are nothing more than inert lumps of skin and bone, although the occasional spasm or twitch does allow hope for full success in the future. I know some of you complain that we should use cadavers and skip the corpse recreation altogether, but you must know we'd never be allowed to experiment with the subject's actual body. We may be working to recreate life, but that hardly allows us to desecrate the dead. Any further complaints can be brought to me directly. Formerus Hughes. I mean, at least he does have some decency, you know. He's trying to make life recreate, but he would not desecrate the dead to further his science. That's a good man right there. I don't care what you say. He's got standards. Oh, this place is in significantly better condition than the outside. Barbara's Hughes, I presume. The hell of a study.
You've made it! And look at you! Even with all you've been through, the Tuatha, your return from the dead. Please forgive me. You must be terribly confused by all of this. I am Fomorous Hughes, and this is my laboratory at Alistar. Everything you see here is dedicated to one thing, the Well of Souls, the pursuit of immortality. And you, you're my first success. If we only had the time, there's so much we might learn from one another.
My death?
I wish I could tell you more, but your death is a mystery to me as well. It seems that your memory died with your body. You see, the well is designed to capture the soul of someone recently deceased, recreating their physical form within its waters. Simple, really. Your rebirth is the first we might truly call a success. There have been others, but the results weren't quite right.
That sounds charming. Well of Souls.
It's been my life's work. Decades of research with a singular goal, ending death itself. And now, you're the only proof that it's a success. But why did it work on you and no one else? What makes you different from the others? There are so many questions to ask, and if we're to get any answers, we've got to get you someplace safe.
Fomorous Hughes.
I am Fomorous Hughes, scholar of Vivification Prime Circle. We're standing above my life's work, the Well of Souls. There's so much to learn about you, though. I imagine it's all a bit muddled. Side effect of the prismia? Shape of the basin? No. If only we had more time.
The Fae.
The Fae are complicated. I could write 10 volumes on the effects of immortality on their pseudo-feudal court system alone.
The attackers.
You don't know. They're called the Tuatha. They were once fae folk of the Winter Court, but they've been twisted by their Lord Gadflow. But how could they have found us out here? We're miles away from the front lines. The war has never touched Dalantarth. And why attack the well?
What's going on?
Too much to explain right now. The Tuatha have come to stop my work, but I don't believe they know about you. Not yet. What's important is getting you out of here safely. You're the only proof of what we've achieved here. I may not be able to save the well, but I can ensure that its only success is safe.
Where are we?
We're in the Feylands, miles away from the front lines. I thought we were safe enough from the war, but it seems some of the Tuatha found their way here anyway.
I've got more questions.
Of course you do. Please, there, we must hurry.
These are all the questions I've already asked. Okay, I'm ready.
Good, good. We can't waste time.
I'll stay and fight.
Absolutely not. I've got my notes, but it's most important that you stay safe. It's just that you're fascinating. Simply astounding. I'm not certain what's caused it, but somehow... Yes, as I was saying, I'm not sure what... Perhaps I should go see.
Sir! Sir! Mr. Hughes! The Tuatha have reached the lab! They're inside the...
Oh, God! Ansel! No! Oh, shit.
No! We've got to get you out of here now! Quickly! Follow the path to the town of Gorhart. Find Agath. He's a friend, and he may be able to help. No matter what else, stay alive!
Oh, he's a scrappy little guy. Goddamn. He's a scrappy little feller. I feel like we should get out of here. Take a quick little look-see. There's really nothing we can get to here, so they're just trying to get us out of here. Alright. Hope it's not much further. Ooh, sprint. Yeah. Take these guys out. A Tuatha Deon. A bunch of bandits. But I can't stand up to me and my rusty sword. Give me a real sword, I'll fight off this whole invasion. Healing potion. And that's a rock troll. Yep, rock troll. Woo! Take out these soldiers first. Try not to get smashed in the process. And now for the trolley man. Ow! Alright, trolley man. Gonna duck out of the way of that. Ow. Alright, let's try not to die immediately here. That's not going. Alright, come. You are slightly more of a match for my rusty sword. Oh, come on, one more. Yeah. That was awesome. That was freaking dope. Alright, I forgot totally about that button mashing right there. All that is an increase to the experience gained from defeating said enemy, whoever it may be. As you go through, as the circle fills up, it hits the points, quarters of the circle, giving you 25, 50, 75, and 100% bonus experience from the kill. Wonderful little feature. It looks like we are finally out of here, and there goes the entrance. Alright, so we made it to Hughes, and we made it out of the Well of Souls at Alistar. So, we're at a time where... a little bit past time, but we're gonna end it right here. And I'm gonna pick it up right here where we left off, trying to find Agarth, I think his name was. His names are confusing and complicated. I'm not gonna remember all of them by any means. But we're gonna go try to find this guy. And possibly, I think there's mention of a town. Anyway, we're gonna pick up right here and continue on our journey. See what becomes of us. And find out what happens in this war, maybe. We'll see. Alright. Till then, I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.